And now the federal government is calling on states to help out. But in South Carolina, the governor is refusing, instead making sure children already in his state get the care they need. Governor Henry McMaster joins us now. Governor, thanks so much for being here. And by the way, Ainslie sends her regards, wants to say hello on her behalf as well.
Thank you very much. Hello, Ainslie.
Absolutely. So how did you find out that South Carolina might be the destination of migrant children, and what are you doing about it?
Well, we got inquiries a couple of weeks ago or more from the Biden administration asking how much space we had in our foster homes. And of course, our foster homes are full. We got about 4,000 children in there and don't have room for all them. There may be a vacancy every now and then, today or tomorrow, but they go fill up. We don't have room for children from another state or much less another country, but particularly when the flow of those children and others could be stopped just by building mm-hmm. the wall and doing the things that the Trump administration was doing on the Mexican border.
Governor, are you confident the feds will comply? I mean, does this mean, this executive order mean they can't, or could they still try to circumvent it?
They could try. It means they're going to have a fight on their hands, and I think they'll have a fight on their hands with other governors around the country. This is not the people of South Carolina's fault. This is not our responsibility. This was made by errors, misjudgments, and a bad policy on the border. I was there last week. I saw the Trump wall. It's big. It's beautiful. Nobody can get over it. They stopped, and it looked like midday. You got tractors, excavators, all sorts of new equipment, millions of dollars just sitting there, concrete getting ready to get poured. And while we're sitting there looking at it yards away, mm-hmm. 100 yards away, you got people jumping over the little fence that the border wall, the Trump wall, is there to replace. They're jumping over the fence and trying to run into El Paso. We saw it. Went to Del Rio and El Paso. We got to build that wall. That's a big mistake. The Biden administration ought to admit that Donald Trump had it right. We've got to build that wall. If we have the wall and strong policies at the border, we don't have these problems in the state. We got enough problems in the states right now without having this added to it.
Yeah, this is not just a border issue. This becomes everyone's issue. And what you're saying is South Carolina kids are going to come first. We've got enough to provide for there. On your trip to Texas, I believe you were visiting South Carolina National Guard troops as well, correct?
That's right. We have about 300 of them there, both in Del Rio and in El Paso. They're tremendous. This is not the National Guard's fault. It's not the Border Patrol's fault. They're doing the best they can, and they're doing very well. But it is impossible to stop the flow of illegals across that border when you got the coyotes and the cartels.
Right.
They've switched to smuggling children and people instead of drugs because it's more profitable. It is impossible
right.
to stop them without a strong wall, the Trump wall there. The Biden administration ought to admit they messed up because the states are not going to be left holding the bag and trying to solve this problem for an incompetent Biden administration policy.
That's ultimately what they want, is to hand it over to states to take care of the problem they created, and you're standing up to them. Henry McMaster.